Hello friends, welcome back, and in this video we are going to see another amazing problem. It's the stone game 7. So it's the third problem of weekly contest. So in this problem it says that it's basically a game which Alice and Bob play. So Alice and Bob are playing this game and Alice starting first, right? So what we can do is we can suppose if Alice start first, so she can remove a stone either from the left or the end right end points, and the score which she get is the sum of the remaining stones. So the sum is, if she remove the left end point, so the sum she get is the sum of the remaining stones. If she remove the right end point, she get the sum of the remaining left stones. So we need to know that first of all that both of them play optimally, and as you know that Alice is starting first, so she will always try that, okay, she wins, so of course she will win. So what we need to answer is, we need to answer what is the like Bob will try to minimize the score difference and the Alice will try to maximize it. So basically both will play optimally, and Alice will try ki her score is as large as possible, and Bob will try his score is as large as possible. So both of these will try that the scores they have is as large as possible. So ultimately we will have the minimum score difference. So we are having an array of stones which will have the stone values, and we need to specify, okay, that what is the minimum difference, which means that we need to basically answer the difference. Okay, so if you know these kinds of games, so it's a basic TP problem. Like you might have seen earlier it as well, but if not then I will let you know. So what happens is that if I have these numbers, right, 5, 3, 1, 4, and 2, so when I'm standing here, so I have two options, either I will choose left or I will choose right. So firstly let us understand this example, after that we will move to the approach, okay, how to solve it. So firstly let us show this example in our case, which means the example this. So firstly you can say that if I have these numbers, right, so as you can clearly see that for now let us suppose that I know what is Alice picking and what is Bob picking, then I will intuit you for this. It's simple that we will check, okay, if Alice picks this, so the score which Alice gets is, first of all the whole score of this array is nothing but 15, right? So if the Alice picks the last number which is this, so the score which Alice gets is nothing but the remaining sum. So as you know that the whole sum is 15 and it was 2, so the remaining would be nothing but 15 minus 2, so Alice get a score of 15 minus 2. Now the remaining array is this, right? Now what will Bob do is, Bob will try to get the maximum score from this array. So let us suppose that we know that Bob is choosing the number 5, right? So if it is choosing 5, so we knew that if my Alice has chosen 2, so the remaining score will be nothing but the number this right here, which is 15 minus 2, so the remaining score is 15 minus 2, right? Now we know that the remaining score is 15 minus 2, which is 13. So I have remaining score 13, which is the score of this right here. Score is 13. If I know that Bob is choosing 5, so the score which he obtains is nothing but the sum, which was this 13 minus 5. So he gets number this, which is 8 actually. And now the remaining array is nothing but this. Now to find what is the sum of this remaining array, we will do nothing. We will simply check, okay, what was actually this number? As I said earlier as well, it is the sum of the remaining array is nothing but the number itself, right? So the sum of this array is nothing but the number itself, as I showed you above as well. So now for Alice, the remaining array was this, right? So she chose the element 3. Now the score which she get is nothing but the sum which we had, which was this sum 8 minus 3. So she get the sum as 8 minus 3, which is 5, right? Now the remaining array is nothing but 1 and 4, and the sum of the remaining array is nothing but the sum itself here. It is 8 minus 3, which is 5. Fine. Okay, now it's the Bob turn. Now what will Bob do? It is its whole sum. Like if he chooses 1, then its whole sum is 5 and he chooses it 1. So the sum, which means that the value which he adds in it is nothing but 5 minus 1. Fine. So now the remaining part will be nothing but 4, and its sum will be nothing but 5 minus 1, which is 4 itself, right? Now it's Alice's turn. What will Alice do? Alice choose the 4 itself, and the sum was already 4, so he get nothing in his hand because now it is empty, and because it was one element, he took it because nothing is empty, everything is gone, nothing is remaining, so he will choose nothing. So the score he gets is 0. Now you can clearly see that, okay, what the score Alice got, it's 13. What the score Bob got is 8. What the score Alice got now was, let me raise it, it was 5. So the score which Alice got was 5. Score which Bob got was 4. Score which Alice got was 0. So you can clearly see that what I need to return at last was their score difference. So I will just simply write the score like this. I will just, because see, I already know that at every step Alice score would be much more, right? It's pretty fine. So I can write it like this, because see, I am subtracting the score of Bob from the Alice score, right? Or you can write it also like this, which means that now, which you can clearly see that at every step I am trying that, okay, if I have any array, if I have any array a like this, so at every step I am trying, okay, what's the maximum score possible, and at every step I am subtracting that, which means that if you look at here, so your array was like this, right? Your array was this, so you try to maximize it, okay, either from the left part, if I had the left element, so what would be the maximum value which I could get, and if I choose the right part, then what's the maximum value which I could get. So ultimately what are you doing is, if you choose, let me erase this, it is like 5 3 1 4 and 2, let me explain it here, 5 3 1 4 and 2. So it's upon Alice that if she chooses the left, so if it chooses the left, then the value which she get is nothing but the sum minus, suppose it is I, it is J, right? Sum minus A of I, right? And now I was saying that for the remaining part, I will find my answer, which would be subtracted from this, which means that if I am having function call from F of I to J, then I will have a function call from I plus 1 to J, because now I choose I. Now I need to obtain the maximum value which I could get. Now why I am subtracting, as I showed you above as well. Here Alice opted first and she obtained value 13. Now the next value, Bob will try to get the maximum value, and it would be same for every step. Now in the next step, I will, as you can clearly see that I am subtracting the value, right? Next I am subtracting the value, I am subtracting the value, which means that at every step I am trying to get the maximum value and I am subtracting it, and you can clearly see that when I am doing it like this, indirectly it will become plus, right? So what I will do, because it's a recursive function, so it's a function and function, function and function, so you can clearly see that if I am thinking of the maximum, so here the maximum starting was 13, then I'm subtracting maximum, and it will be 8 for Bob. I'm subtracting maximum, which will be 5 for Alice. So now I'm subtracting for Bob, but indirectly I'm adding for Alice, right? I'm subtracting for Bob, so indirectly I'm adding for Bob, right? So it was the main logic that I will subtract for Alice, which is this, right? But as you can clearly see that for the next stage, I also need to have its sum, because my sum is also reducing at every step. So I also need to pass my sum, which is nothing but sum minus A of I, as I showed you in the explanation as well, because at every step, my sum is nothing but the number itself, which I got. So my sum is nothing but sum minus A5, which is this. But now, as I said that either I can choose for left or right, right? So here I choose the left element, but what if I had chosen the right element? So now I will choose the right element, which is this one. So next, what I could do sum minus A of J, because I choose the rightmost element. Then I will do the same thing, but now my remaining array is nothing but I minus I comma J minus 1, because here I use this, so my remaining will be this. Now the sum, remaining sum would be nothing but this, which is the same value as this. Now I had two options, either left or right. What I wanted, I'm Alice. What I wanted, because I'm the first one starting. What I wanted was I need to get the maximum. So I will just get maximum out of these two options. It's a simple DP. Very standard ones, because I hope that you guys have seen that standard DP in which we opted for the first element and call for the next part and for the right part, but it's much easier. So you can simply make a DP of I and J simply and simply do it. Let me show you the code. It's pretty simple, pretty simple. First of all, I had the sum, as I said that I need to know the sum at every step. So I will find the sum. I had my n, which is size of the array. I found my sum in this step, which is the sum of my, you know, array. Then I initialized my DP with minus one, the standard procedure of initializing DP. It's a DP of size n plus one and n plus one, because we already know that we are having the values which are changing the function is I and j, right? So we are having these. Then I simply have a function call, which is, as I said, that I will have I, j and sum. So at every step, I also need the vector. So I also pass the vector, because like it's very standard that either you can make your vector globally, which means the vector this, or you can have it in your function call. Then in this, you can see the function, I have my I, I have my j, I have my vector, I have my sum. Now, first of all, as I said that if I have only one element remaining, so answer is zero, as you can clearly see that at the last one element was remaining, so he will choose it and the remaining is nothing, so he will not be able to increase its score, so the answer would be nothing but zero. Very fine. And the standard procedure that if it is not minus one, so I can return it because I have a value, I will just memoize it. Now in the next step, as I found the answer was nothing, the equations I showed you, it would be nothing but, firstly it would be maximum of what? Maximum of nothing but sum minus that particular ith element minus f of remaining, which means that I plus 1 to j, and the sum would be nothing but the sum itself here. Or what I could do, I could choose the jth element, so my sum would be, which means that value added would be nothing but sum minus jth value, and I will minus the left part, which means I to j minus 1, and ultimately I will return my answer. So it was all. I hope that you guys have got the proper logic, intuition, why you did, how you did, how you applied DP, how you thought of doing it. So I hope that you guys got it. In the next video, we will see the next problem. So yeah, until then, be happy and keep coding. Bye.